1.2, The Process of Science by Jaden Song and Alessandra Cao. Introduction. Biology is a science that gathers knowledge about life. Discoveries are made by researchers using mutually agreed on methods. Part of their methods include careful observation, record keeping, experimentation, submitting conclusions for others to inspect it. Some scientists use practical applications such as the prevention of disease, such as figure 1.15, which is the Escherichia coli is a bacterium that lives in our intestines that are typically harmless, but also sometimes is responsible for disease outbreaks. This micrograph shows E. coli visualized using a scanning electron microscope and digital colorization.
The nature of science. Science is defined as knowledge about the natural world. However, science cannot explain moral questions and spiritual questions. Science cannot answer these questions because it is out of the realm of material occurrences. The scientific method consists of steps with experiments and observation. A hypothesis is a suggested explanation for an occurrence which can be tested. A scientific theory is accepted through tests and confirmed explanations for observations made. There are scientific laws, which are typically mathematical formulas. It shows how elements of nature behave under certain circumstances.
Natural science. Science is such a diverse field that includes astronomy, biology, computer science, geology, logic, physics, chemistry, mathematics. Natural science is the field of science related to the physical world and its processes. There is a range of opinions on defining what natural science is. For some experts, natural sciences include astronomy, biology, and chemistry. Some scholars divide natural sciences into life science, biology, and physical science, astronomy, and chemistry. Figure 1.16 shows the fields of science.
Science inquiry. The ultimate goal of all forms of science is to know. Curiosity and inquiry leads to the development of science. Scientists often use two methods of logical thinking, inductive reasoning and deductive reasoning. Inductive reasoning uses related observations to arrive at a general conclusion. Biologists often make observations and record them. Data can be qualitative, which is descriptive, or quantitative, which is using numbers. Raw data can be obtained from drawings, pictures, photos, or videos. Scientists can infer conclusions based on evidence.
Scientific inquiry continued. Inductive reasoning is concluding generalizations inferred from observation and analysis of data. Brain studies consist of the observations of brains while people are doing tasks. The part of the brain that lights up, activity taking place, is demonstrated to be part of controlling that task. Deductive reasoning is logic used in hypothesis-based science. The pattern of thinking is opposite from inductive reasoning. Uses a law or general principle to speculate certain results. From the general principles, scientists can predict that the results are valid when the general principles are valid. A prediction would be, if the climate is becoming warmer in a region, the distribution of plants and animals will change. Both of these methods of logical thinking are related to descriptive science and hypothesis-based science. Descriptive is to observe, explore, and discover. Hypothesis-based begins with a specific question and has a potential answer.
Basic and applied science. So what is the value of science? Do we pursue science to gain knowledge, or does it only have value if the knowledge can solve problems? So there's two types of sciences, basic science and applied science. Basic science, also known as pure science, is the intention to expand knowledge. It doesn't focus to be a product to serve the community. Applied science, which is technology, is to use science to solve problems in life, such as a cure for diseases or to improve crop yield.
Basic and applied science continued. Some may think basic science is useless, but having a basic understanding of science is necessary before anything is developed. Applied science relies on basic science. An example of how basic and applied science can work together is the discovery of the DNA structure. Understanding the mechanism of DNA, basic science, such as the process of DNA replication, helps to develop technology that can identify genetic disease, which is applied science. Another example of both sciences working together is the Human Genome Project. Study of human chromosomes to determine the sequence of DNA subunits and location of those genes. The study needed basic research, and the end goal was to use the data for applied research for seeking cures for genetically related diseases. Figure 1.19 shows the Human Genome Project was a 13-year-old project among researchers in different fields of science.
Reporting scientific work. Scientists must share their findings to other researchers where they expand on it. Scientists must communicate and collaborate with their peers and share their results and publish them in scientific forums. Peer review allows for research to be logical and thorough. Grant proposals are requests for research funding. Results of studies published on forums without peer review aren't reliable. However, journals may let a researcher to cite personal communication from another researcher about unpublished results.
Thank you for listening.